Hi everyone! I have another baby shower cake for you, and this time it is for a girl. This cake can also be made for a boy, just switch the colors to blue. Make sure to check out my rubber ducky baby shower cake at Cake 2 if you want another idea of a baby shower cake. Alright, let's proceed on to this video. To make this cake, you are going to need the giant cupcake pan or mold. I bought this one online and I'll post the link down below. I put the mold on a cookie sheet for easier transfer, and then spray baking spray on it. Then pour your cake batter into both molds about 3/4 way in. I am using a chocolate cake recipe that calls for using 2 9-inch round pans. In your preheated oven, you want to bake the cake for about 50 minutes. Depending on your cake recipe, it might take longer, so make sure to insert a toothpick in the center to see if it comes out clean to know that it is ready. So once your cakes are baked and starting to cool, pop the cakes out of the mold and let them cool down completely. Now you are going to need the bottom cupcake mold for the next step. Make sure it's dry. And you are going to need these pink candy melts, blue if you are making it for a boy. I poured all of the candy melts into a microwavable bowl and microwaved it for about 2 minutes, stopping every 30 seconds to mix until it is completely melted. So my pink candy melts didn't come out to be runny the way I was hoping to, so I'm not sure exactly what went wrong, but it is still workable, so I'm going with it. In the mold, you want to pour the melted pink candy melts and just make sure everything is covered. I used a spatula to help me out with this step. I also have another video when I made the giant cupcake roses cake and the chocolate is runny there if you guys want to see it. I'll post the link down below and somewhere on the screen. Okay, then place this into the fridge for 20 minutes to let the chocolate harden. Once the chocolate has hardened, you are going to want to remove it from the mold, and this is the scary part because you don't want the chocolate to crack. I started from the sides and slowly was pulling the mold down. Take your time doing this if you have to. Keep pulling down until the chocolate has released from the mold. Hopefully that wasn't too bad if you guys did this. Leave that aside and now it's time for the cakes. So take both of your cakes and you are going to want to level them. So just level the top of the cake from the bottom part of the cupcake so it has a flat surface. And then the top of the cupcake, level the bottom part. For the bottom of the cupcake, I trimmed the sides of the cake so it can fit into the chocolate mold without it being too tight and cracking the chocolate. You want a little bit of space between the chocolate and the cake. I then placed pink frosting into the chocolate mold, which is optional. To make the pink frosting, just mix a little bit of red food coloring with cream cheese frosting until you get your desired color. You want the frosting to be a lighter color than the pink candy melts. Then place the bottom cupcake part into the chocolate mold. I then frosted the top of the cake and placed the top cupcake part on top. Now it's time for the frosting part. I placed the pink frosting into the piping bag with the big star tip. I started at the top and you want to pipe a small amount in the center and slowly work your way around until you make a rose. For the next rose, you want to make it as close as possible to the other rose. Then repeat until you cover the rest of the top. And that is how you make a giant cupcake cake with roses. But because this is a baby shower cake, we're not just done yet. I used a baby rattle toy that I bought from Michaels in the baby shower section and filled the plastic part with chocolate pearls. You want to place it right on top of the cake. Now, I also took some pink fondant and rolled it about to 1/4 inch thickness and using my letter fondant cutters, I'm spelling out the words, "It's a girl." Then place that on where you want the front of your cake to be, and that's it. Like I said earlier, you can also make this into a baby shower cake for a boy and just switch the colors to blue and write it's a boy instead. It's super easy to make, and if you guys do, take a picture and tag me either on Facebook, Instagram, or Twitter. I would love to see your pictures. Also, don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Thanks for watching!